Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to export a video or export part of a video in CapCut on PC. So here I've got CapCut open on my PC and I have two clips imported into this project. And I'll just add both of these clips to the timeline by selecting them and then dragging them onto the timeline. Now currently both of these clips together are about 30 seconds in length. And if I just wanted to export both of these clips together, I could go up to this button that says export. And then here you'll find various settings that you can change with regards to the exported video. The first one being the title. You can change this to whatever your video is about. I'll just call this export test. And then you can choose where you want the exported video to be saved to on your computer. If you click on this folder icon, it'll open up a new window on your computer. And then you can choose the location where you want the exported video file to be saved. So once you're happy with that, just go ahead and click on select folder. And then you have these two options. The first one is video exporting and the second one is audio or sound exporting. Now here in video exporting, you can choose the resolution up until 4K. You can change the bitrate and you have some preset options here like lower, recommended and higher. And if you click on customized, you can enter a custom bitrate and also choose between CBR and VBR. I normally just leave this on higher. But one thing you have to take note of here is the higher your resolution and the higher your bitrate, the bigger the file will be that's exported. As you can see down here, this 30 second clip is estimated to be 155 megabytes. Next, you can choose the codec and you can choose between these three codecs. I always use H.264 as it is the most common compression method. Next, you have the format and you can choose between MOV or MP4. Usually YouTube recommends that you use MP4. I use MOV, but this setting doesn't really matter that much. You can test out these two settings and see what works best for you. And then next, you can choose the frame rate and you can choose between any one of these options. I normally use 30 or 60 FPS. Now, if you scroll down to the bottom to where it says export audio, this is currently unavailable as I don't have any sound added to this project. So let's just go ahead and add some audio to this project. And I'll just add any sound effect here just to get access to this export audio setting. So if you turn this on, you can export the audio to a separate file, meaning you'll have a video file which also has audio in it. And you'll have a separate audio file with that video file. And once I go ahead and export this project, I'll share an example of what I mean. But for the separate exported audio file, you can choose any one of these formats. And I normally just use WAV files. And then lastly, you can also run a copyright check just to check if your video contains any copyrighted material. Now, if I go ahead and click on export to export this video now, it'll export the entire timeline, which is 30 seconds right now. But if I go ahead and click on cancel, and I only wanted to export a certain part of the video on this timeline, what I can do is I can move my player to the position where I want the video to start. In this case, I'll have it start at the beginning of the clip. And here I'll just zoom in on the timeline a bit so I can see what I'm working with. And now let's say I only wanted to export 5 seconds of this clip. I'll move the player to 5 seconds and then I'll press O on the keyboard. Now, if I zoom out, you'll see this part of the timeline has become darker and that's because it won't be part of the exported video. So what I've done here, I've added an in point at the beginning and an out point on 5 seconds. If you go ahead and click on this keyboard shortcut button up here and you have a look at these two settings, which is in point and out point, by default, it should be set to I and O. Those are the keyboard shortcuts which you can use to add in points and out points, meaning if I wanted my exported video to start here on the timeline, I can move my playhead to this position and then press I to set the in point. And if I wanted it to end just before this clip ends, I can move my playhead to this position and then press O. That means only this part of the video that you see here will be exported. Now I'm just going to go ahead and move this sound clip into the exported area. And now I'll go ahead and only export this part of the video by going up to export. And I'll just rename this again. Now you'll see this clip will only be 6 seconds long and I've chosen to export both the video and the audio. Now remember, you only have to have this checked if you want a separate audio track with the video track. And I'll go ahead and click on export to show you an example of what that looks like. Now once your video is exported, you can go ahead and click on this button that says open folder. And the folder with the exported files will then open on your computer. And if you only had the video exporting option selected, you'll only have one file in the folder, which will be the video file. And if you go ahead and double click on that, it'll play the video clip. If you had both the video and audio exporting selected, you'll have two files, and the other one will be an audio file. And if you go ahead and double click on that, it'll only play the audio. So that is how to export a video or a specific part of a video in CapCut on PC. And if this video helped you out, please like the video, and I'll see you in the next one.